for now, because it's like, I know that, there are going to be some tough decisions that have to be made. And I know you're not only playing this game as, you know, with Festy Besties, but also for your personal game. And I respect that, as long as you're honest with me. I'm, I don't know who would be mad about it, because this is a game, but you know what I mean?
Yeah.
I get it. Like, the way Danielle reacted today, I don't think I would ever react that way, because it's like, it's still a game. Like, it's not life or death for a person. It's a game. So, but you know, maybe, you know, he just really felt really close, and maybe he felt like that was the only person she had. I'm not faulting him for that, or somebody having emotions.
And I think part of that too is he could have left things the same and she'd still be here. I think in my head, I'm like, okay, I get it. Like, if
I also think he was upset because he felt like, because he saved Indy and Alyssa, that they were going to vote like how he wanted them to. But at the end of the day, like, that was his game to, you know what I mean? Like, that had nothing to do with them. Like, it was still, like, obviously it was still his preference to, and it was nice, but like, I don't know. It's just a tricky situation. And I don't know. I don't know. I'm not trying to, like, put a target on his back, but now I'm thinking, like, you know what I mean? Like, I'm just like, I don't want people to feel uncomfortable. Like, today when we were all, like, during the live shots and stuff, he was like this the whole time. He did not look up, give eye contact. I paid attention the entire time. He didn't look up, give eye contact. He didn't kiki. Like, it could be something that was happening right beside him, and he was just like this. It was like he was almost forcing himself not to look or participate. So that's why I was like, okay. So that scares me a bit, because now I don't know what you're capable of. You know what I mean?
And I think someone with nothing to lose is very dangerous.
Nothing to lose. Because, like, who does he have? Like, Nicole was really it. I mean, yeah, he tried to, like, talk to people and do things. But I'm like, I don't know who he has. So this was like, I don't think that he does have anybody, which means that he's like, fuck it. Like, even when he was like, oh, I know I'm going home next week. So, like, I don't know. Like, damn, like, why would you say that? Like,
I am interested to see what he's going to have to say, but
I mean, but he literally just said your name.
Exactly. Which was just like, I don't know what you're doing here, but
I want to know if Nicole whispered anything to anybody.
Not that I noticed.
I don't think she did she?
No.
Okay, that's what I was. I was like trying to pay attention to like people hugging to see if, like who she like talked to, but if she said anything, no, I was right there when she talked to Daniel, like when she hugged him, and it wasn't anything game related. So like, I don't think that was anything.